Here's our last example of a use substitution that is not a perfect trade. As you can see, I have stuff in the denominator with an exponent. So probably the first thing I'd want to do is bring up that stuff upstairs and write it as a negative exponent. Okay, cool. All right, so what I'm going to have here is that u is going to equal 7x minus 1. Okay, so right now this is going to be u to the negative fifth. So actually, let me go ahead and write that to the side. I've got a u to the negative fifth. So that's what this piece to this piece is. Boom. Okay, now I still have to make my trade. I still have a 2dx left behind. So let's go down here. Du is going to equal 7dx. Okay, well, I got a problem. I can't really make my 2 and my 7 match. So when you have this happen where your coefficients are not going to match at all, what we're going to do is we're just going to worry about trading the dx. That 2 is going to still be over here. Okay, so the 2 is still going to be over here, but I'm now just going to trade out the dx. So to make this deal for just the dx, I would get that du over 7 equals dx, or 1/7 du will trade for dx. Okay, so that 2, I couldn't really figure out what to do with, but I'm going to have a 1/7 du now that I just traded for. All right, cool. So what's going to happen is that 2 and that 1/7, they're going to join forces to be one coefficient, which is a 2/7. And then this u to the negative fifth, we're going to go ahead and integrate. So add a 1. Then divide. Okay. Now I'm going to go ahead and combine all these coefficients. So this would be 2 over negative 28, which is the same thing as 1 over a negative 14 or negative 1/14. Okay, that's the reduced form. And then u to the negative 4 would look like 1 over u to the 4. But I'm going to go ahead and get it ready to substitute back in. And u was 7x minus 1. So that's what's going to go in here, 7x minus 1. And there we go.